إن الحمد لله نحمد ونستعين ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. I greet you all with the greeting of Al-Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I was not expecting to be here tonight, neither you know I'm going to be here tonight. But of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aware about everything. But what happens is he cancels the flight. I don't see any snow yet, but قدر الله وما شاء فعل. The flight was 6 o'clock, so was no anything on the ground for a flight not to leave, and it is a direct flight. So, but anyway, Allah subhanahu wa taala knows best. But it's something very important that we as Muslims would need to learn something. That we be prepared to take disappointments in this life and to have sabr when a calamity or bad news or whatever that happened to us, and to understand that we are here slave servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are not the one who make decision. Allah is the one who decide whatever he wants, and it's good for you as a slave servant of Allah that you be, number one, patient with Allah's Qadr, number two, that you try to be pleased with Allah's Qadr. Okay, there is two different level, okay, with the calamity. Some people, they will have sabr with the calamity. Some people, they will have sabr and be pleased with Qada Allah. And some people will be pleased and have sabr and be pleased and also be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? So, we have to understand that we have to be prepared for things not to go according to what we want or what we like. Doesn't go towards our direction. This is something that we have to be ready for at any time to happen to us. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَبَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَ قَالُوا إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Indeed, we belong to Allah, and to Allah we shall return. O Allah, reward me, journey fi musibati. Reward me regardless of my calamity and give me a better than what you took away from me. But you don't know where is the good. This is something very important. We as a human being, we don't know where is the good. The good is not what you want. The good is what Allah chooses for you. And you have to know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala arham bi'ibadihi min al-walidati bi-waladiha. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most compassionate, most merciful towards his slaves more than a mother to her baby. (Clears throat) Therefore, that we have to be ready to submit and accept whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give to us. You don't know where is the good. And Allah told us in Quran, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Perhaps you may hate something, okay? You hate something, but there is good in it for you. And perhaps you may like something, and there is something bad and harmful for you. Then Allah ends the verse by saying what? And Allah knows and you know not. You see? It's not what you think. It's not what you feel. Of course, we as a human being understand you like to live in time. You like to be in your comfortable house. You like to be around your children. You like to be around your mask. Take care of your business. Make sure things are okay. You like different things. And now flight cancel. Now you don't like this. But you don't know. Okay? So it's not what we like. It's not what we dislike. We have to learn how to submit and to accept and surrender to Allah's decision, because Allah knows and we know not. Okay? We don't know not. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying in the hadith, which is the meaning is, عَجِبْتُ لِأُنَاسٍ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ بِالسَّلَاسِلْ أَوْ فِي سَلَاسِلْ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. I'm surprised to some people being dragged to Jannah by chains. What does this mean? Okay, as example, here I was planning to leave, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to give me some blessings by sitting in the mosque and by giving some information. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want me to drop a seed. And some people may take this seed and benefit themselves or benefit somebody. Okay? So what my likes was different. But now, okay, Allah give me something. That He give me a good in it and reward in it. At least that I'm able to deliver a word of Allah and hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is something good. You see? You was planning to come, make Maghrib and leave, and the dinner waiting on the table, and. But something else. Your mind is there, and we would like to be there, and the weekend, and tomorrow. But this is good for you. You want to be there home. You want to be with the children. You want to eat the dinner. You want. But Allah decreed something for you, else, for you to hear something. You understand? It may be more beneficial for you even. That's the dinner. We eat dinner every day. But we don't hear classes every day. Okay? And sometimes only one word that you hear it in a class or in a lecture can make a big change in your life. It can ease your burden and your problems that you're going through it. Okay? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows. And we have to believe in Allah's knowledge. And whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doing it is with wisdom and hikmah. Allah doesn't do anything for foolish. Okay? وَمَا خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا لَاعِبِينَ. هكذا الآية. Okay? We did not create the heaven and the earth and what between them for foolish reason, plain, waste of time. No. There is a purpose. There is a purpose for every action of Allah and every decision of Allah. And for us to believe in Allah, to believe in Allah's attributes, in Allah's knowledge, He is Alim, Khabir, and He's Hakim. He's knowledgeable, He well acquainted with things, and He is with a full wisdom. So the Prophet ﷺ saying about some people, they go to Jannah, okay, but by dragging them to chain. How? That these people was non-Muslims, okay, and they go in a war against Muslims. And the Muslims, they win the battle. They will take them as what? Captives. And now they change them, so not to run or whatever it is. But they took them as a captives, And Allah will bless these people to get the opportunity to see Islam and Muslims and hear it, they embrace Islam. So actually they've been dragging to Jannah with Salasil. Subhanallah. But when he fall into captivity, he doesn't want this, he doesn't like this, but he didn't know that this captivity is going to bring him to something that's going to be better for him than the whole dunya, and this is the Jannah. So it's something, subhanallah, it's so beautiful. The more that you, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَمَنْ يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهِ, and whosoever believes in Allah, Allah will guide his heart. So the calamity, when it falls on a Muslim, different when it falls on kafir. And with the calamity when it falls on a believer, is different when it falls on a Muslim. And the calamity when falls on a muhsin will be different from the mu'min. Because your iman in Allah, what is the ayah? إلا في كتاب ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في السماء ولا في أنفسكم ولا في أنفس إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها. Allah says there is no calamity, there is no any bad news that happening to you, okay? Up, down in the heaven, in the earth, or in regardless of your property or yourself, unless that is already in a book before even its existence. You understand? Believing in Allah, believing in the Qadr of Allah, okay? Believing in the Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you really have a belief in it, now when the calamity falls on you, will be much easier than somebody who doesn't have the belief in the Qadr, and knowing that Allah knows everything before its existence, and Allah had wrote it in a book, and it will manifest and take place exactly as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not just now Allah know will be a snow. It's not just now that Allah will know such and such. No, it's been written before the creation of the heaven and the earth 50,000 years. So when you have this iman, and you have this aqidah, when the bad news or the calamity fall in you, it doesn't hit so hard. Why? Because you know, like what you call when you have shocks in your car and you hit a bump and you have a good shocks. You understand what I'm talking about? Anybody know what I'm talking about?
Yes, yes.
Anybody still awake? Okay. So you know the shocks in the car, okay? When you hit a bump, okay, and you have a good shocks, you did not feel the impact so hard in you, okay? Like if somebody doesn't have shocks or bad shocks. Why? Because the shocks will take some of this impact. So when you have the iman, you understand? This is the shocks, okay? This is the shocks that when the calamity falls in you, it doesn't hit so hard. Why? The iman is there. And it's going to help, it's going to ease. So Allah said, وَمَنْ يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهِ, whosoever believes in Allah, Allah will ease his heart. Now we're taking it, you are not going to take it where you understand shouting, screaming, and sad, you are not going to eat, you don't want to talk to any. Why? Because the iman is there. Okay? The iman is there. Let me tell you about a story from the life of the Sahaba, may Allah be pleased with them. I didn't prepare anything for you tonight. Actually, I'm going to open it for question and answer. This is my plan. But this is a small introduction. It may be we benefit something. It reminding myself, and inshallah will be a reminder for you. Zawjat Abi Talha, Umm Sulaym, okay, the wife of Abu Talha, may Allah be pleased with her. She had a baby, and this baby was sick. Right, and have a fever, and you know, okay. So Abu Talha went about taking care of business or wherever he went, and it happened that the boy passed away, he died, okay. So أم طلحة أم سليم she said to the neighbors no one informed my husband when he come about the death of his son until I be the first one to inform him. Listen to this story, it's so beautiful. Look how the strength of their iman, their belief, okay, said no one to inform my husband when he come about the death of his son unless I be the first one to give him what you may call it the bad news. So when her husband came back from his trip, he asked her, how's the child? She said, هُوَ أَسْكَنُ مِنْ قَبْلَهُ هُوَ أَسْكَنُ مِمَّا كَانَ عَلَيْهِ He's more calmer than before. Okay? Because you understand with the illness and sickness, baby crying and fussing, but now he's more calm. She meant something, but he understood something different. Okay? So, and this, what you call ma'arid. Ma'arid, that you say a word, the listener will understand something different from what you actually meant, but still using the same term. Okay? إِنَّ فِي الْمَعَارِيدِ لَمَنْدُوحَةٌ عَنِ الْكَذِبِ So, he took it to understand that he's sleeping or it's calm. He's not to understand like fussing all this problem. Anyway, she prepared dinner for him. Served the dinner. He sits and eat. And after this she goes, take a shower, put nice, attractive clothes in her. And after this he go and sleep, have a relationship with her, intimate relation. And after this, okay, she asked him a question. He said, if some of our neighbors lend us something, okay, somebody come and say, can I borrow your shovel to remove the snow or whatever? Okay, they lend you a shovel as example. And now they come in asking you, can we have the am I going too fast? Can you understand me?
Yes.
You sure? Okay. I'm sorry, I don't know how to say Bangladesh, brother, so you have to be here. You accommodate me. Bismillah. So she said, if any of our neighbors lend us a tool or something, and now they want it back, would this upset us? Would disturb us? He said, no. This is here. Okay? Somebody said, oh, brother, please, can I use your truck because I have to move the couch? Okay? And now he come in and say, I need the keys. You give him the keys. Is this it? Okay? And you say also, thank you. Huh? Zakallah khaira. So he said, no. Why? Okay? Why are you going to be upset? It's a loan. You didn't buy it. You don't own it. It's a loan. Said, then, فَاحْتَسِبْ waladak. Said, then, count your reward with Allah concerning your son. That means to try to teach him and to remind him that your child is a gift from Allah, is like a loan. And now the owner of this loan, now he wants it back. How you can be, you understand, upset about it? But when he heard this, he could not believe it, you understand, say, how come he did? Yeah. Because you understand, giving me dinner to eat, make me relax, make me feel good, everything. And after this now he's coming to give me the bad news. And he ran to who? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to tell him about what's happening. Like, look, how she can do something like this. But this is what? A believing woman. Strong faith. Can you imagine a woman? Because you see, and this is a good example for our wives to learn about the Sahaba and the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all these things. How she entertained and how accommodate her husband, especially when a husband coming back from work or traveling, tired, all these things. And the first thing as soon as they go, oh, both on you. Sorry, No. As if nothing happened, want to make him comfortable, everything is okay. And after this, give him this so-called bad news. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, "Arrastum tilka layla?" Did you have a relation? Did you intimate relation together? He said, yes. He said, Barakallahu lakuma fi laylatikum. May Allah bless your night. That means the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam agree and confirm and goes with Umm Sulaim had did concerning the way how she kept the bad news from her husband until he make him comfort, and how she gave him the news after this. And the narrator of the hadith is saying, from that night that Umm Sulaim was a pregnant with a child, which is this child, later on when he got big and got married, he had 12 boys, and all of them memorized the Quran. So the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Okay? So this is a way to see the sabr, patient, how to deal with calamity, how to be patient when something happened, and how also you always to go back and to understand that, since we're talking about it also, talk about the beautiful gift that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had give us concerning the sabr and the rida and the shukr to Allah in time of calamity. And the calamity, what can be calamity to you, maybe it's not calamity to me, because we are different. Somebody his flight is delay is a calamity. And somebody understand the flight is canceled. This is both of them calamity, but this is, and somebody who's going to a meeting, going to make $2 million in one contract, is not like somebody understand who's going back home. It's different. Although the same thing, cancel the flight, but everybody, and also a believer and disbeliever, Muslim and mu'min, the calamity is going to be. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he had informed us and told us about something very beautiful, that if somebody, a calamity fall on him, and he make ihtisab, that means say, Alhamdulillah, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, Allahumma jurni fi musibati, wa khlif li khayran minha, unless Allah will replace him with something better than what he lost. So, now, Umm Salama, may Allah be pleased with her, she say, when her husband died, she said, I remember what the Prophet said, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying that anyone, you know those people who left after Maghrib for their dinner, they lost all this good stuff we're talking about, huh? So I'm giving you the dinner. This is the real dinner, okay? When you go, what dinner? This will be the dessert, okay? You winners, guys. And they winners also, because they met Jama'ah, but they have other. But anyway, Umm Salama, when her husband died, radiallahu anha, she said, I remember the statement of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which he said, that if somebody, okay, have a calamity, lost something, or something happened to him, and he utter the dua, all praise is due to Allah. Indeed, we are from Allah, and to Allah we shall be returned. Okay? Oh Allah, reward me in regardless of my calamity, and give me better than what I lost. Not only give me a reward, but also give me what? Better, you know what? Not, huh? No, better, not equal. She said, so I thought and I think, who can be better than Abu Salama? Because a woman could not love or see any man can be in her life to her more than her husband. And she said, for a moment I started thinking, who can be better than my husband who passed away? There's no way. Abu Salama, this is my husband, father of my children, and she said. But, she said, the Prophet said, I have to do what he said, and this is it. Because, yes, with your vision, with your short ideas that no one can be better than what, nothing can be better than what you lost. But you don't see. How far you can see? How much you can think? You can see if you stand here in the window and you look, you can see what? Down in the street, about what? 2 miles? 3 miles? 5 miles? And after this, can you see? You don't see. You, is it blind? No, you are not blind. Nothing there? No, there is something. Your vision has a limitation. And your thinking has a limitation. Everything is limited to you. Okay? So, what is not limited? That you believe in what Allah said and what the Prophet said, because what Allah said is the truth and what the Prophet said is the truth. All what you need to submit and do what Allah said, what the Prophet said, the result now comes from Allah, you will see. Okay? But she could not see anything. She looked to all these people that she know, all the Sahaba, you could not even think. Doesn't matter how more rich she is than her husband, still this my husband. But she said, so finally, I said it because the Prophet said. After her iddah finished, somebody knocking, somebody coming to make a proposal for Umm Salama. Who? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is the Prophet better than Abu Salama? The Prophet better than all the Sahaba. Allahu Akbar. Can you imagine? And that he himself coming to ask her. Okay? He's coming to ask her to be his wife. Subhanallah. Brothers, we so rich with Iman. We so rich millionaires with the deen. But if we really believe in it and put it in action and follow what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us, and we believe in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us. So Allah said, وَمَنْ يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهِ. And whosoever believes in Allah and the qadr of Allah, Allah will make his heart what? Go when the calamity happen, his heart will be in ease, like they call it, like a watermelon, like nothing. He will be relaxing, good, okay? He's not going to be shouting, he's not going to stop going to the mosque. Some people, any small thing happen to them, say, man, forget it. I'm not. Detect. Remove all the beard, stop making salah, stop going to the masjid. Oh man, oh yeah, this man. Only FBI comes and put a business card on his door and leave his number and say, understand, we need to see you in the office. Oh man, forget it. FBI want me? Oh, this is a... What's going on? What did I do? Huh? This, I'm not going to go with it. No more masjid, huh? Why? What happened? They only want to talk to you. You clean what you worry about. Go to the FBI or go to... wherever, whosoever, okay, yes, I'm here, what do you want? What question you got, okay? But some people, for any little trial, any test, huh? Right away they're thinking about what? Let's clean, let's leave this business about Islam alone, we don't want to have more trouble. You'll be tested, okay? And you think you'll be better than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah tested him. The Sahaba, may Allah be pleased with him, been tested. They lost the battle of Uhud. And in the battle of Uhud, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kusirat raba'iyat wa shukka wajuh. His teeth, front teeth been broken. And he been wounded in his head. All this is test. Ghazwat al-Khandaq. All this. So we have to be prepared for what can happen to us, and we understand that everything happening is by Allah's knowledge and by Allah's will. People could not take away from you or give you other than what Allah had decreed, and you have to always turn to Allah and be strong in your belief. I'm going to stop here because if I can keep talking, I can. Allah knows best when I'm going to be finishing, okay? But basically, what I thought that we can sit down, since I'm going to be here for the night, that we, if anybody have question, usually we have, you understand, only question in the subject and it's limited time. So alhamdulillah, today this is your action, okay? You can bring any question. You can, you understand, take your time. And I like question and answer because sometimes you hear classes and lectures, but there is something bothering you. You won't talk about it. You don't find the opportunity. And also I like question and answer. Why? Because sometimes I be asking questions that I don't know or I'm not sure about the answer. So this, it give me like dafi' or give me a push that I go and search the subject more to come with the answer. So inshallah, we're going to start from the right. And after this, we'll come again. After one round, we'll go back again. You understand from the right. Yes, sir.
Thank Allah.
Okay, Jazakallah khairan. ممكن أكلم بإنجليزية تفهم. طيب خير. So that means I have to translate your question now. He said, if two statements of the companions are contradicting each other, which one of them we shall take? And he gave example. The example of Adhan Uthman, that Abdullah ibn Umar.
Adhan Uthman أضاف الأذان ثاني لما كبرت المدينة.
نعم نعم.
Yes.
Abdullah ibn Umar said that this adhan that been created or been initiated by Uthman, may Allah be pleased with them all, that is innovation. So now one person did something and one person, you understand, contradicting what is said. Which one is correct? I may be answering part of the question and it need a small introduction, and I hope that you be patient with me, inshallah. First of all, what Uthman did is not as a form of ibadah. Okay? We are forbidden to add anything in the deen. Okay? Not to add anything in the deen. So Uthman, when he started the adhan, okay, he did not make adhan as a part of the deen, but as a alarm clock, alerting the people. As a result of this, he did not, okay, or approve for this, he didn't do it in the mosque. But he did it on a Zawra. This is a marketplace in that time. That because the people became more in his time, and farther distant from the mosque, okay? So he made somebody to call adhan in the marketplace ahead of time of Jum'ah, so the people to know that the Jum'ah getting closer and they will close their shops, go take shower, prepare, and all the things, okay? So with this, the statement of Ibn Umar that this is bid'ah, okay? So this is correct. And the action of Uthman will be bid'ah if he brought it in the mosque, okay, in the same time of Jum'ah. But Uthman didn't do this. The problem today is not Ibn Umar and Uthman. The problem is that we did not go by the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is one adhan. And even if, let's assume there is ta'arud, what you call contradiction. So, alaykum bi sunnati. So you don't go عليك وسنة الخلفاء. You start with number one, who's the teacher, who's the prophet, who's the, you understand, the imam is the prophet. So we have the action of the prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one, and then in Jum'ah we have in time of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq one, and then we have in the time of Umar one, and then, okay. And Uthman radiallahu anhu, he knows this, so he did not, you understand, make two adhan in the same time, in the same place. You see? So with this, is no problem, is no negotiation. The problem nowadays, when we bring, we did not take the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ by making one adhan, neither we make the sunnah of Uthman, which one adhan in the marketplace before Jum'ah and one then is a mosque. So you got it. خير إن شاء الله. Okay, we're going from again from the right. تفضل.
بدي سؤالين. السؤال الأول ما هو الدعاء الذي قلته عن أم سليم التي عندما انتقل ولدها إلى رحمة الله عز وجل قالت هذا الدعاء هي أم سليم.
لا 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 هذا قصتين مختلفتين التي قالت واخد بالك هذه. أم سلمة.
أم سلمة.
الحمد لله إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون اللهم أجرني في مصيبتي واخلف لي خيرا منها. أي أعطني أفضل مما افتقدت وجاء من هو أفضل منه الحمد لله. الله أكبر.
السؤال الثاني قيل أنه بدعتي نوعين
بدعة
حسنة
وبدعة سيئة
فهذا صحيح؟
نعم. The question here it been said that there is a good بدعة and a bad بدعة. بدعة حسن بدعة سيئة. I would say this statement is not from the Prophet neither from the Sahaba. It's from a scholar and this statement is wrong. Because the Prophet, you see, we have to go first, always the Prophet. You don't jump, see, leave all this and you come to somebody today, said, or yesterday. The Prophet said what? فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. Indeed, every innovation is a misguidance. And every misguidance, it will lead to hellfire. So if the Prophet say كل وهذا لفظ للشمول فمن أخرج من الشمول هذا أكد بأنه ها وقال كل كما يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل مسكر خمر فهل الخمر فقط ما كان سائلا فالرسول يقول كل مسكر خمر. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم the same way he said كل محدث بدعة he said every intoxication is a khamr and every khamr is haram. So now it doesn't matter if you're going to drink or you're going to sniff or you're going to chew or you're going to shoot, as long as it makes the absence of mind, this is what is khamr. Okay, so how come we use kul in the khamr, that any khamr, any intoxication is wine? But we come here and say, no, it's not every bid'ah. Okay. But if the scholar who said so meant that there is a bid'ah hasan and bid'ah sayyah in the dunya, we can agree with him. Okay? We can agree with him. But our concern about in the deen, is there a bid'ah hasan in the deen? No, there is no bid'ah hasan in the deen.
Fadl. As an example, Fadl. Like when we say, for prayer, you say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, Hayya 'ala as-salah, Hayya 'ala al-falah, Qad qamat as-salah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. Some people, they say before they pray, La ilaha illallah.
Okay.
So is it bid'ah hasana? Am I saying bid'ah hasana?
Okay.
Ana qultu annaha bid'ah, walakin ba'd an-nas qala hadhihi bid'atun hasana.
Hasana. He say that when you make the iqama and the person makes the iqama, the last statement say la ilaha illallah, a lot of people say la ilaha illallah. So we said to them this is a bid'ah. Okay, which is correct, it's bid'ah. Now somebody answering him, it is a bid'ah hasan, it's a good bid'ah. Now let me answer how I'm going to answer this by the following. Is Quran something good or not? Is the Quran something good or not?
Yes.
We agree about this? Okay. Now after I finish reading the Quran, I say, Allahu Akbar. In ruku' قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٍ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدٍ. Why? It's Quran, akhi. The Quran is more excellent than any dhikr. Okay? But we say, yes, the Quran is good, but this is not its place. The Prophet didn't teach us this. If it's good, why the Prophet didn't teach us this? You see now? So the logic, akhi, man, Imam Malik rahmatullah alayhi said, what the meaning is, man istahsana, شوف, man istahsana fi al-deen faqad sharra, wa man sharra faqad ittahama Muhammadan sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bi'annahu khana al-risala. Whosoever with his logic on the sense is good, because his logic is no statement, is no evidence, is only logically is good, it seemed to him is something good, that whosoever add anything to the deen, okay, that means he make a legislation, he adding, he make laws in the deen. Whosoever do so, he accusing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he betrayed the message. Anybody willing to do this? You could not, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had conveyed everything. Is it? Adda al-amana? Ballagh al-risala? Is it? So, and Allah said what? الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ. Today I had completed the religion for you. So if the Prophet didn't say this, neither we understand that the Sahaba said this, who's me or you to say is okay to do? What do you mean is okay? For what dalil you say is okay? Why, if it's something okay and something good, why the Prophet didn't tell us to do it? Look, after the adhan, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, taught us that you say salah, durood, ala Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and after say Allahumma rabbi hadhihi da'wati tamma, and all this. So after the adhan, there is salah ala Rasulillah, and there is a dua, and the Prophet taught us this. So why the Prophet also did not tell us? Okay, or another logic, since it's a matter of logic, so why we are not saying the whole ikama, why only the last one? Only understand? So, alhamdulillah. Okay, we're going from? You need to move to the other side so you can be... I come back to you, I'm sorry. Yes, sir.
Two questions. First one is, ma'arif, is it a white lie? The English one is a white lie. Is that the same thing as ma'arif?
White lie.
White lie is basically, you understand, right? When people say something, but it's not complete lie, it's not the complete truth either.
No.
What is the ruling of that?
It's
the story that you mentioned when the husband came and she said...
Yes. Yeah. Okay. So the word, it can be used in... two meanings, and you said it with a meaning that you meant. As example, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam been asked by one of the eyes or the spies of the kuffar, he said, from where you are? He said, we are from ma, okay, we are from water, okay, that Allah created us from water, okay. So the man left the understanding, because now I'm going to expose my secret, okay, I am Muhammad and this Abu Bakr, and you understand that, okay? So the man, he took it and assuming that there is a village or whatever, some place called Ma, and he kept walking. And this is it. So the Prophet didn't lie, and the man also come, you understand, with. So we use this ma'arid sometimes that we need it, but we are not lying.
Just attached to
sure.
Can a husband use that on...
No, he must. Not he is. He must. Yes. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he permitted lies in three conditions. And you know this already, okay?
Lying is
permission?
We said lying is
three conditions? Yes. That means... حديث الرجل لزوجته وحديث المرأة لزوجها. يعني يقول لها ده أنا بحبك أو ده أنا بموت ده أنا...
They can't lie. They can't like each other.
Huh?
They can't like each other.
Not lie about, you understand, oh, okay, okay, where is the girls? Oh, they're sleeping in the room, okay, and the kids, they understand, was in the neighbor house. I mean, hadith al-rajul li zawjatu, okay, oh, I love you so much. He likes her, he doesn't love her, really, okay, but, you understand, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made them is a way that to keep this relationship, and you know, you understand, they like to hear this, compliment, ooh. I could not wait for you to cook again. Mashallah. You understand this thing? Okay, you got it? And islah bayna nas. You see, okay, no, Akhi, brother Iftikhar, he really want to talk to you and want to meet you. There is nothing, akhi, in his heart. He say, I have nothing in his heart, with a misunderstanding. And you go to you also and said, okay, the other brother has, so because he want to make islah. And the other one is in the war. Alhamdulillah. So now, this is permissible according to the Sharia. Yes, sir.
The second question is, can we take a story from the Sunnah, from the Hadith, and share it with non-Muslims, let's say in academic setting in college, and if you mention the word Allah and Muhammad, they won't listen to you, but you want to convey that message. Can you use that as a story, and you say everything, let's say a husband, a wife, this is what happened to the son, etc., etc., would that be something that's okay to do?
Why not?
Okay.
Why not? Okay. And Allah knows best. Right. We'll continue. No questions?
Yeah.
No questions? Further.
Okay, you know, sometimes like husbands and wives, some husbands, they always want like their wife to listen to him only. And whatever wife says, like he doesn't care or he doesn't listen. Like in that case, what should the woman do?
And this is what?
What should the woman do? Like, you know.
She has to be patient, okay? The brother saying that he wants his wife, whatever he say, that mean he will say jump, she will say what? How high? But whenever she say anything, that he doesn't listen or nothing. You see, it's not, you understand, we have to be reasonable. Yes, the husband, he's the imam, he's the man, he's the have the quama, he have. But also you have to understand, to be realistic, okay, inshallah, honey, I'll think about it. Okay, let me try. I'll see if I can, okay? We have to know. We understand well. What about if we wait until tomorrow we can do it? I don't think we can. It has to be reasonable, you understand? Akhi, me and you, we did not obey Allah in everything. Come on, okay? And this is Allah. Who, you understand, obey Allah in everything 100%. So, we have, you understand, to be reasonable, and marriage life need, you understand, to learn how to be easy going without being, you understand, breaking the tie. So if she pull, you let it go, okay? And she let it go, now you pull. But both of you pulling at the same time, it doesn't work, okay? It doesn't work. And we can see how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we need to study the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how he used to be kind and gentle with his wives, you understand? He said to Aisha, I know when you are mad at me and when you are not mad and when you are pleased with me. Say, how, O Prophet of Allah? He said, when you mad at me, he say, by Ibrahim's Lord. Okay? But if you're happy with me, he say, by Muhammad's Lord. That means the Prophet was so sensitive even to the feeling, he can say from her words, she's okay with him or not. And this is the Prophet of Allah. So, akhi, this mentality of army in the house doesn't work. Okay? Yes, you are in charge, but you have to have the wisdom how to lead the family and how to make your marriage successful, inshallah. Okay? Sure.
It's based on yesterday's lecture about divorce. Let's say the husband doesn't pray, but the wife is praying.
Okay.
But he doesn't force her, like he doesn't tell, like he doesn't stop. Force her to stop praying. So he lets her pray and do all the obligation part. But he himself,
okay,
he's the role model, like, you know, he's the charge, like,
okay,
in the family.
I understand.
In that case, should she divorce him just because he doesn't?
In that case, nicely talk to him and talk to him and talk to him. I made dua for him. And after this, you understand, with all the trials, said, see, I love you so much, I care for you, I want to be with you all my life, you understand, but I'm sorry.
Goodbye.
I could not continue like this, and please, if you are not, I'm going to have to ask to depart from this. So we don't want to understand, okay, listen, I give you 24 hours, you better do your example. It's not going to work like this. Okay? And sometimes the way how we present things, it will make difference. Okay? So, we need to advise We need to make dua. We need to really care. Listen, let me tell you one thing, brothers. The person who are in a sin is like a sick person. He actually sick person, he or she. And you have to be, have kindness, concern. You act like, you have to be like a doctor for him. So if he said, he's sick, and I could not touch you, understand, you, germs, and come on, the man need your help. So if we go and you understand, like this, it's not going to advise this. Okay, honey, I know you like basbousa, so I made you this kunafa tonight because you understand you like this dish, and inshallah, I hope you understand that because I care for you. I want, and she show her concern, her love to her, and after this, would you please, okay, I want you to lead me into rak'at, okay? I want to, you understand, to be behind you in salah. I love to see you lead. She have, you understand, to use her techniques, her wisdom, how inshallah can bring it. But if after she try, she want to get out of this, it is her right.
But if she wants to stay, she could stay, or she shouldn't?
Unless she gave up that he never going to be praying. If she feel a little bit hope there. When Ramadan come, he can start to pray and things like Yeah. So that there is a hope. There is a hope. Okay? Yes. Oh. Ferris. Oh, yeah? But you got your question from the internet. You're supposed to ask the question.
The internet has given to me to ask you. From
the audience. From the audience. Okay.
So it's a man versus a woman to stay with
you. You see, now Brother Iftikhar is going to be mad at me now because he came this way after it.
He can join me here.
Okay.
He played a trick, but he stayed there. So
can I take him first? Yes. Please. Okay. To have justice. Okay, brother. Okay. Huh? Zakallah. You see how nice Bangladesh people are sometimes?
Okay. So, if a man forces a woman to stay with her parents,
Yusuf. Hey, please. 1 second, so I can hear.
Okay. So, if a man forces a woman to stay with her parents for a few months, in that case, what should be the best for the wife to do?
He forced her?
Yeah, to stay with her parents.
I think if she's a wise wife and she care about her family and care about her marriage, she will do it.
Sister, the parents.
Yeah.
Her own parents. Yeah.
You see, we have to listen. It's a shame.
Actually, could you tell again that we're hearing the questions?
A husband imposing in his wife that she need to go with her family to stay for 2 months. Maybe he have a problems, or he understand things is not going well, or whatever it is, he need to get his priority in order and things like this. So, he, like you say, he want to get, you understand, my head straight. So, if she, wise woman, alright, she want to save her marriage, okay, and in some culture, if a woman been married and get divorced, this is the end of it, alright? She can be even 25 years old, and this will be it. She never married again. Okay, so she have to be wise. Okay, I'm going to go, but I really understand, could not, but I understand this, your wish, da-da-da, but okay, and we keep with contact, emails, phone, you understand? So she have to be wise. And he's not ordering her something haram, but it must be a reason, you understand, that he won't, you understand, to do something like this, inshallah, okay? So she should be wise, and try to answer, you understand, to meet his wish to save her marriage, inshallah. And 2 months is not going to kill her, akhi, inshallah.
But he must have a reason.
Exactly, okay? Yes, akhi. Iftikhar.
We should go from here.
You're getting hard now. I'm coming back again this way. Akhi, Iftikhar, please sit down. Jazakallah khair. May Allah reward you. So beautiful. Bangladesh people, akhi, have a lot of sweet people among them. You see, was this my mistake? Before I got married, I didn't know too much about Bangladesh people. So it's too late. Make sure that my wife doesn't hear me on the internet now. Go ahead.
Talking about the, you know, the blood, you know, the outside the bad condition of the weather.
Uh-huh.
And it is, if it is the bad condition of weather and there is a jama, you know.
Uh-huh. Combining salah. Yes.
And combined salah, some masjid, actually, we don't know, some masjid, after Juma, they, you know, not combined the salah.
Uh-huh.
And some masjid, they against the, you know, combined the salah.
Okay.
Basically, the Juma.
Uh-huh.
It's going to be happening in Bangladeshi masjid, they're not doing like this. They never pray Juma, combined. But
okay.
In Arab masjid, some Arab masjid, we say this scenario, somebody after...
I got the question. I understand. See, akhi, combining the prayer is permissible, all right, without traveling. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did it, and Ibn Abbas reported this, that he prayed in Medina, 8 and 7. Okay? That means Dhuhr and Asr and Maghrib and Isha. Okay? Min ghayri matarin wala safar. If I'm not mistaken, the hadith. Okay? That without raining or traveling. So the combining was not because he was traveling. Okay? And not because you understand a rain. They ask Ibn Abbas, why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did this? He said, Arada Allah yuhrija ummata sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He wished not to have a haraj or
hardship
in his ummah. Okay? So we understood from the hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had made permissible to combine between the prayers in the time of rain or bad weather. Now, some people, they make exception for Jum'ah, but this is a no dalil on it. If it happened in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or did not happen, what will make the Jum'ah as exception? If there is no dalil to make it exception, so we can combine. Okay? But it is permissible. Those people who are not in the masjid, okay, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to order the muazzin to say, in bad weather or rain and things like this, sallu fi rihalikum, sallu fi rihalikum. Okay? Pray at your houses. After say, hayya ala salah, hayya ala falah, or instead, hayya ala salah al falah, he would say what? Sallu fi rihalikum. That means, pray at your houses, don't come. Okay? So those who are in the masjid, they will combine their prayer. So it is sunnah, and it is something that has been done, and was no problem. There is no dalil to say you could not do this for Jum'ah. And Allah knows.